Hi everyone, Zormar here. Welcome to my channel and greetings from Paris. I've been here for a few weeks and it's almost time to fly back to the US. Today I'm going out shopping, so this is what the vlog is going to be about. I'm going to take you with me to some of my favorite shops in Paris. If you enjoy watching today's video, give it a thumbs up. It really helps my channel. Consider subscribing. I'd love to see you around more. Now let's go shopping. First stop of the day before I head to Sezane is Ateliers Auguste. Their store is in the Marais neighborhood. I really wanted to see this shop in person. I previously had only seen their bags online. Ateliers Auguste is a small brand. It's family owned and the bags are made by hand in Italy. Their designs are contemporary and minimalist, and what I really like about the brand is that it is not a big brand, so you are not very likely to see a ton of people wearing the same bag as you, which I feel like in today's day and age feels like quite luxury when you have something that it is not mass produced. They have core designs that keep coming back season after season, like this one that comes in two sizes. But what they do is they do limited edition different leather colors or leather textures, which I think it's a really interesting idea. I am a fan of this taupe color and this bag in general. Oh my god, if you are a girly that likes to carry more things, this is one of the prettiest bag of this size that I've seen lately. There was so much to try. I have to say that I thought coming here in person will help me narrow down my choices, but I think I just have more wants now than before coming. Seeing these bags in person, they're just so well made and so beautiful, and I just want one in every color and in every design. Definitely check them out. They are a brand that should be on your radar. I'm gonna link them in the description box below. Now let's go to Sezane. Imagine this being the entrance for your apartment building. So dramatic. I was quite surprised when I arrived at the Sezane store on Rue Saint-Fiacre that there was a line outside of the door wrapping around the block. Usually I've seen lines like this only during weekends, to be honest. This is early in the week, early in the morning. I think it's just because everyone was really curious to see the new collection releases, and I cannot blame them. I was surprised that they had this basket with the daisies in stock. It's sold out online. Really liked this wallet. Very nice that they have multiple sections to put money and credit cards. This one is really cute as well. And I have a newfound appreciation for the Faro bucket bag. I don't know why I strayed away from it for so long. It was the first bag design from Sezane that I bought. I have it in a chocolate, like a deep chocolate brown. And the new colors are making me smile. I am definitely planning on adding some colorful version of the Faro to my wardrobe. I really like how the pink matched my sneakers. This croc ecru one was also really fun and elegant. I browsed the knickknacks. Everything was color coordinated and I just wanted to get all the little bags and all the souvenirs. They do such a great job in making you want things. The store, by the way, inside, it was madness. I didn't get to shoot many of the racks because look at how busy it was. This is me trying to get to the fitting room and it was a battle. And the wait for the fitting room was maybe 30 minutes, which I guess, given how busy the store was not as bad as it could have been. First, I tried the Pippa dress, size extra small, in this beautiful lavender color, and I think I'm getting the hype. This dress is so comfortable, it's so easy, it's like throwing a t-shirt on. Perfect for the warmer days ahead of us, and I think this color is my favorite from all the new releases that we've been seeing lately. I also really like this set. It's so comfortable, it feels like liquid butter. It's so soft on your skin. I love how the pants are draping there. Excessively long. You have to hem them if you're around my height, which is, I am 5'6", which is 168 centimeters. I love it as a set. It is really, really nice. I also did try the shirt with this knit skirt, and honestly, when I saw this skirt online, I didn't think much of it, but it is really beautiful in person. It is flattering. I love the colors. I love how it hugs my curves. And because San Francisco doesn't really have a real summer, I thought this will be a great pairing for the Emile cardigan in this lavender color, which I've been eyeing, but I got the light yellow instead, and now I'm wondering, did I make a mistake? Should I have gotten the lavender? I don't know. And I wanted to just show you the shirt by itself. It drapes so well, and you can see with jeans, it's a very easy everyday pairing that you can do in a more casual way, or you can dress up if you want to. Sezane is really good at designing ultra feminine white blouses, and this one is no exception. I love the ruffles. I love the embroidery. This is size European 34, US 2. She's a beauty. What can I say? The new purple Max. The material is a little bit stiffer than the blue and white striped Max that I have, but I still really like it. The color is a little bit more vibrant in person than you see in this video. For some reason, the lighting of the fitting room was really not doing it justice. It's a very comfortable, everyday style. I really liked it. If you're looking for something less colorful, I thought this dress was really great. You have an ecru base with brown stripes, and then you have these really thin pink ones. It's just a very easy, everyday piece that you can dress up with a heel or wear with a flat sandal. I tried this dress. I really like elements of it. I like the ruffle on the shoulders. I like the color, and the back is really beautiful. I just wanted to try a size bigger just to have like a little bit more room. Unfortunately, they did not have it. If the San Francisco has it next week, I'll definitely give it another try. Now let's go to the next store, which will be Rouge. Usually this location is not too busy, but I don't know what's going on today. Everyone is out shopping. I managed to film a little bit without getting anyone in the frame. The current collection is really nice. I am excited to try quite a few things, and I was chatting with the sales girl who told me that I should definitely stop by the Rouge location in the Bon Marche. I was looking for one particular cotton blouse that I saw on their website, and they didn't have it in this flagship location, but she told me that it's really likely that the Bon Marche will have it. So I guess in the part two of the Paris shopping vlog, I'm doing two parts because otherwise this will be too long. In the part two, I am going to show you the Bon Marche location, and I'm gonna share my thoughts on how the stock compares between the flagship location and the Bon Marche location. I tried quite a few of their bags this time, and I have to say they're really growing on me. The designs are really nice, the shapes are good, and I did not get one this time, but I'm thinking I should add a Rouge bag to my collection at some point. This suede one was really beautiful. I collected everything that I wanted to try, and it was available in my size. So let's head to the fitting rooms. This cardigan, really comfy and really cute. I like the shape. It is slightly tighter around the waist, so it accentuates it. It is part of a set, but they did not have whatever the set comes with. I'm not sure if it's pants or a skirt. They just told me it was a set. I tried this t-shirt as well. I had high hopes for it, but I didn't like how it fits me. I think this design will fit really good on someone who has a bigger chest, like a more feminine shape. The print is beautiful and the cotton was really nice, really soft. The star of this try-on, without a doubt, was this dress. If you follow me on social media, you saw it the moment I tried it, and many of you fell in love with it. It is no secret, I got it. It's even my current profile picture on Instagram is me wearing this dress. It's my favorite Rouge dress that I've ever tried. It is just such a nice combo between the cut and the print. This print was also available in this top. I thought it was too much to own two pieces in this print. If they had this top in another print, I would have gotten it. I wish they would do more of that, like take one silhouette and make it in multiple different prints. I also tried this top, which I thought I needed a size smaller. They didn't have it. My go-to size for Rouge is 36, which I think corresponds to the Sezane 34, to be honest. And everything I've tried today was 36. This just happened to feel a little large in that size. I finally made it to Balzac Paris. When I ask for recommendations for brands that are similar to Sezane, Balzac always comes up, but somehow I just never made it to the store. This is my first time seeing their pieces in person. I've been following them on Instagram for quite some time, and my first impression was that this store is gigantic. I expected it to be like a small boutique, but it is huge. One thing, even though the store is huge, they were out of small sizes from almost everything that I wanted to try. I was talking to the salesperson and they told me that recently there was a restock at Galeries Lafayette. Galeries Lafayette also carries Balzac Paris. So if you're a fan of the brand or you really want to try their pieces, when you visit Paris, try to go both at the flagship store and to Galeries Lafayette, and this will increase your chances of getting a piece in your size. I was really surprised just how many things were not available in my size, but I did grab as much as I could, even if it wasn't not in my size. At the back of the store, there was a secondhand section, which I thought was really cool. I didn't figure out what's the origin of these pieces. Are they secondhand from customers? Are they secondhand, like, are they samples? I wasn't sure, but pretty much everything was around 50 or 60 bucks. There weren't a lot of sizes, but I thought it was really cool that they had this very big secondhand section. So I grabbed pieces and now we are going to try them. This sweater was one of my favorites. It was the only one they had left in this pattern. The contrast sleeve, the stripe with the cheetah print, I thought was really fun and really different. I haven't seen a design like this. This oversized shirt I thought was really fun. I like the colors. You can see the seam on the shoulder fits where it's supposed to fit, so I know that the size is right. I really wanted it to pair this shirt with the cheetah jeans, but they were just really huge size. I couldn't even just put it on for the video. The same shirt design available in white. And look how different it looks just by using a different color. It's like a completely different shirt, isn't it? This set I thought was really on trend. I've been seeing matching sets like this with boxers and shirts everywhere. Like almost every brand has a version of this. And if it's not boxers, it's long pajama looking pants. So this look will be the look of the summer. Everyone will have it. I, again, really wanted it to try this shirt with the cheetah jeans. Too bad they were so, so big. And I really liked this dress from the secondhand section. I love the neckline and the sleeve, but it was size 32 and it was just too tight on my chest. Like, you can kind of see how it kind of pulls, like between the shoulder and the chest, it just pulls. Otherwise, I would have gotten it. Bobbies is a shoe brand that I see a lot of Sezane fans asking questions about online. They have quality shoes with beautiful designs. I visit their store when I can when I'm in Paris. Oftentimes, the store doesn't carry the full collection, and this time I went to look for these sandals, and unfortunately, they were not available. In terms of sizing, I fit in size 38 from Bobbies, which is also the size I wear from Sezane. European-wise, it's 38. That Sezane translates to US 7. So if you are Sezane US 7, you will probably, just like me, fit in the Bobbies size 38. I hope that helps you if you are planning to buy from them. In my next vlog, I'm gonna go to Jonak, which is another shoe brand from Paris that is really popular. Okay, I wanna get to the Arket store. All the way there past the construction. I really hope that one of these days Arket will start delivering to the US. I like their aesthetic. It's very minimalist. They offer clean cuts, quite contemporary. The color palette is classic. It's very limited. Very versatile options. I would say their designs are inspired by the row. If you're not familiar with Arket, they are owned by H&M. They are more expensive than H&M, but cheaper than COS. I really liked this tote bag that I tried at the store, and I don't know what's going on, but today I think I fell in love with bags in every store I visited, which makes things complicated, because originally I thought I would just go to Polene Paris, which will be featured in part 2 of this shopping vlog. And I thought I would just get this bag that I was thinking about, but now I don't know. Now I have a lot of favorites and I might go in a different direction. I really liked this sweater. I like the color and I like the texture. This is size 38 and I am usually size 36 by Arket. And since this cut is already oversized, I think 38 just makes it a little bit too baggy. I wish they had 36, but it was sold out. This V-neck top I also really liked. I like the length of the sleeves. It's just such a classic, such an easy piece to throw over a pair of jeans. I can see it with a flat or like with a low heel. It's just really nice. This navy checkered dress was very comfy. I loved the texture of it. I liked the slight puff on the sleeve. And it does have pockets. The length was really nice too. And overall, the dress was light as a feather. The only thing is, I thought the waist felt a little bit odd on me. Like, it wasn't high-waisted and it wasn't a full drop waist. So that threw me off a little bit. This sweater I also liked a lot. The texture of it was really, really great. But again, this is size 38. And because the cut is already oversized, I thought I definitely needed a 36. This was probably my favorite. It was my size 36, and it is the same material as the first sweater that I tried. Just the color was more beige, and the sweater that I tried was a little bit more yellow. But yeah, I hope Arket comes to the US. I think they have great pieces. Well, this sucks. It is raining like crazy. I would say I'm not prepared. And I look like a wet rat now. All right, everyone, this is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my Paris shopping vlog. Let me know in the comment section below, what do you think of the stores I visited? Which ones should I visit next time? I want to know. If you enjoy watching today's video, give it a thumbs up. It really helps my channel. Keep subscribing. I would love to see you around more. Have a wonderful week and see you next time.